promise that you're not really faithful. Yeah, baby, you're not heaven sent. It's dangerous, I can see you're not an angel. Yeah, I know this could be my end. Somehow I love when you lie to me. Look at my heart.
what up? We early again. I'm getting fucking cooked from these 12-hour fucking 10-hour streams. Holy fuck me. I started falling asleep an hour ago, and then I had an alarm set for fucking 1:30, and I like fell asleep for 10 minutes, and now I feel fucking fantastic. Not really. Holy fuck my life. Why am I doing this to myself? Time to start drinking. Oh God. Little devil, I hope you know yesterday I said on the stream, I'm like, I just want to fuck with Yuki. And it's not really supposed to be part of the arc, but I'm just fucking with you just because I'm good. And then fucking Mari goes along with it and just made it all the more fucking better. It was great. I enjoyed that way too much. Granted, I did do it to Mari too, when Mari said, do you want to marry me? Reggie's just like, yeah, okay. Everyone was just like, what? Oh, it's too easy. Too easy. All right, so today we got to see who else is around and start getting people to move into gear and start prepping themselves. We actually need to have a chat with fucking Yuki properly as well. So make sure you get your ass in. Get a good cue. You'll get yours back? Probably not. Probably not. Won't happen. We got food, don't we? We do. Good. Not too drunk. Oh God. Oh God. All right, let's get a car. Do I have money on me? Nope, I got $4. One day that cunt will take fucking card instead of cash. Eat. One day. Got no mods. Time for fucking riots and anarchy. Atom. Oh, these long ass streams are cooking the fuck out of me. We've also got to chat with Benji and fucking look at that. I need to make more money so we have a buffer. Morning, Lucy Lou. No, I haven't. I'm guessing it's like, fucking hard lemonade. How many have you had already? That's the real question. Buy a bed from Freddy. Fucking make me. Ooh, a gray one. Fancy. Fancy. All right, let's go fucking tuck ourselves in somewhere. So we talked with Smalls, we talked with Dre yesterday, we partially talked with Mari. Are you only about to start now? Wait, you just finished work. It's 2:30. Q's not till for another 3.5. Oh my goodness. Okay, you're probably going to be pretty toasted by then. You're gonna be pretty toasted by then. All right, no new messages. Also, what's a goog day? What's a goo day? Have a goo day. Also, this was me fucking with both you and Smalls, because I was guessing you guys were gonna be together, so I sent the exact same message to you both. I enjoy that too much. It's great fun. I was waiting for you to be like, hey, Reggie sent me this. Hey, you sent me the same thing. What the fuck? All right, who else have we got? Who else? Anyone we need to start fucking brainwashing? Veronica's around, so that means that Nick's around. Look, Benji and Benji. Turo would be probably pretty good, but I don't know how he'll go actually being around. Oh, Ellie. Ellie. I need to talk to Ellie. Definitely need to talk to Ellie. Ba-dum-bum-bum. Okay. Call Ellie. Where was it? Back later, have a good stream. All right, have a good one.
Hello,
how could you do this?
What do you mean? What did I do?
How could you do this?
What did I do?
Out of all the people you could do this to, you do it to me?
What did I do?
I know damn well what you did.
I have no idea. But like, if we were to be like that, how could you? Like, I gave you my number and everything, and you didn't even like text me. You didn't call me.
Okay, to be fair, I kind of like, I forgot to save your number.
Damn, that's fucked up.
I'll own up to it.
How could you do that?
Quite easily. It's called, I was busy and then thinking about a lot of things, and then I had a number thrown at me, and then I was too busy thinking about the other things and then moved on with life.
Yeah, that's fair.
Yep. I need to have a chat with you.
What do you have to... Oh, okay. I'm doing group 6 at the moment.
Where are you? I'm coming and to then... rob you.
Polito.
Oh, I'm not coming to rob you then. That's too far. That's way too far.
Uh-huh.
Alright, give me a call when you're done with your run.
Yeah, I will.
Alright. Bye.
Alright, bye.
Alright. Let's call Benji. Hello, Tiger! Stuck back in here and talk to Benji. I'm not going to be able to multitask with his ADHD.
Hello, it's Benji Ramos. How can I help you?
Ain't no way that's how you answer the phone to me.
Oh, sorry.
What the hell?
What's up?
What the? Do I look like one of your fucking clients? What the fuck was that?
Okay. Yeah, my phone's not working. What's going on?
Jesus Christ. Can't believe you didn't save my number. So the wheels are set in motion from what you said the other day. I had a chat with Smalls and Dre. They're both doing the thing that I said that they were doing to you. Dre seems like he's got his head around it pretty well, and he's just going to be hard pushing to be able to get the drying racks. Are you paying attention?
No. Hold on.
Fuck. And it begins. Are you paying attention? No. Hang on, hangs up. We need fucking KJ to wake up. That's what we need. Wait, I forgot that I needed to do this. No, or did I already do it? Oh, it's still at 60. Good. I upped that. Our plan is to find more people, work on them, get them doing shit. Right, so let's have a look at houses. The house is a necessity at the moment, right? Oh, they're getting bought. People are buying. People are definitely buying. Oh, they are buying. That was 35 grand. That was 35 grand. Then it went up to 70. Now it's 110. Fuck. I think going for a 400k mirror park is better. I honestly think going for a 400k mirror park is better. I doubt you're going to be able to sell these back for the same price, right? So, okay, let's have a look at it. That's too many. It's a lot of runs, man. That's across four people. Like fucking 20 runs a day of group six. If they take half an hour a turn, it's 10 hours of it. Fuck that. Oh, so now you call me back.
Yeah, sorry, there was a little bit of manning stuff going on. I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. What's screaming? What's up?
Well, like I said, the wheels have been set in motion from what we talked about the other day. I spoke with Smalls and Dre. Dre seems further ahead than Smalls with what he's doing. Smalls refuses to fucking talk with Dre and collaborate together to work to the same goal. So that's its own frustrating thing. Basically, I told them that this time around, we're only picking up people that are beneficial and that are actually making a name for themselves. If they're not doing that, you're going to be left out. So you need to start doing that shit.
Okay, good shit.
I told them straight up, we're not taking any freeloaders this time. It you ain't coming along to hitch along to the ride. You are a part of the ride.
So, okay, good shit, bro. Let's do it.
I'm also... Okay,
what we end up doing, we need to make the Maonies.
I've also been, I started talking with Mari a bit, because I think she will be beneficial with that. I'm gonna have a chat with Yuki and Ellie as well.
Okay, all right.
So I'm gonna start branching out more. I need KJ to wake his bitch ass up so I can pass on the information to him and get him to start doing it in the later hours as well.
Okay, all right.
All right. Is there anyone else appreciate you want me to reach out to that's usually around when I'm awake?
All of them, bro. Because the thing is, essentially, if people don't start working, then AU is legit just dead.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know what I mean? If I like, I don't know how to make this sound like I don't know how to make this make sense. AU, if people aren't really there, it's going to be like, I just want it to be active. You know what I'm saying? And I think somebody was screaming in my fucking ear.
Yeah, listen, I already get that. I'm gonna start working that. I think that honestly, out of everything, probably Dre and the girls are gonna work the fucking hardest on this, but we'll see what happens. I tried to prod Smalls. Is he kept saying to me that he's gonna reach out to Dre, but then never did, and I don't think he will. I think he sees Dre as competition for some weird reason, but if he wants to waste his money on stuff that Dre might have already fucking learned, then go for it.
Nah, if they see each other as competition, then that means they just don't fuck with each other, bro.
Yeah.
Simple.
Yeah, which is stupid though, because you're going to the same goal.
That's always gonna be a thing though. Like, they might not want to be going towards the same goal. That's my drift, bro.
Oh, that's not meeting our goal, is it?
Yeah, then if they're not, this is the thing, bro. I need to make you and KJ successful no matter what.
Yeah,
you get what I'm doing, right?
Yeah.
It makes me successful in the long run with Seaside or not, because I told you yesterday, right? I'm putting everything into the company right now, 100%. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And that needs to be done. Yo, Arturo, hold 1 second. Okay. It's Benji, brother.
I did consider Arturo, but I don't know if he's gonna fucking.
It's been forever. I love you, bro. Arturo is here. He's bald.
Yeah, I know. I was hanging with him the other day. I don't know if Arturo is gonna be one that's gonna want to like do that kind of shit, but we'll see. I mean, might. You could have a chat to him.
We will. Okay. I'll give you a call again. I'm gonna be around for a little bit. I'm not gonna just disappear without calling you. Okay.
I'll talk to you later.
Okay, I got you, brother. Appreciate you. Okay, thank you.
All right. The next talk is Ellie talk. Surely Benji won't forget. And we don't really need to talk again. I've already communicated what I needed to. So that's done. All right, so today we've also, I want to make hopefully a couple of grand in the time that I'm around today. If we can make 2 grand extra today, so get us up to 12k, we might be able to throw Dre $500 to start helping him with his shit. But I also want them to do it themselves and not take handouts. No, we won't do that. They need to get their own handouts from other people. The whole point was for them to prove that they want to be doing this stuff and doing it, so I shouldn't hand them out money. Okay. We'll just work on the money and keep the money aside. We'll do that. Whatever we do this time, I do want to have more females involved into it, so we can actually grow from the start from there. That's what we need. Like, I want to have a nice diverse range of people that can make a name for themselves, that are smart with being able to manage their own money and work towards a goal. That is what I want. We know previously that Mari, Ellie, and Yuki were all great with that kind of shit. Even though Yuki didn't have that much money, she still could start doing things. She just needs to be pushed a little bit further out to do her own thing. I want to do Tong just yet. I want to wait for Ellie. Love that talk. We need people that can connect with other people. That's the point, is we need people that can talk and connect with other people. And as funny as it sounds, for some reason guys in the city will always give information to the girls. Just how it is. Just how it is. I put the mask back on. I can't see the lights. It blanked out for me. Or do we want to go have a chat with Ellie? The fuck is happening over there? So many fucking locals. Where do we want to do this? Actually, I know where we'll go. Hello.
Hello, I'm just about to finish my run. Where are you?
I can pick you up from group 6 if you want.
Yeah, I'm about to pull up now. See you soon.
I'll be there shortly. Bye.
All right, bye.
Legal. Sound like shit, like shit.
I'll give you a call, okay?
Sounds good, take it easy.
Right. Bye.
Well, if it isn't the person who forgot to save my number.
What do you mean you forgot to save mine? You never even gave me yours. If you had given me yours, I would have saved it.
Mine was always in the yellow pages.
I didn't actually think it was that night.
That's a lie. Didn't even look. I can't believe you've done this.
Okay.
I can't believe you've done this. How could you do this to me?
Can you take me to a clothing store?
Do I look like a Gruber? The hell?
You want to have a chat while I'm dressed up like a fucking security person?
Makes me feel safer.
Oh. I do have a knife.
So, how's life been?
Life's been good. Just trying to get back on my feet, you know. Running into people that I haven't seen in a really long time. Okay. A little bit of group 6. I did some Sani today, which sounds really, really fucking horrible, but I have a lot of materials now.
Right.
So Sani is not bad. It's pretty quick money too.
Right.
I also got hired as a mechanic today.
All right.
The popular street one, so it's Chip and Vinny's shop that they're opening up.
The enemy.
Oh, do you work at Mosley's?
No, but Dahlia does.
Oh, okay. What about you? What have you been up to? How you been? How you feeling?
Living my best life. Working, walking, breathing, yeah. Living, eating. You know, the usual things.
Yeah. Okay, I'm good.
Oh, okay. All right. Well, that was easy. So we're going to be here for like an hour or something.
No. I just needed to get out of that.
Da-da-da. Go drive somewhere and then we'll get out so you don't have to listen to the car.
Okay, sounds good.
How long have you been awake for?
A few hours today. I actually was not super unlucky with the train.
And you waited for me to call you?
How am I supposed to know you're awake?
Ellie.
You didn't give me your number.
Ellie.
What?
I expected better from you.
I didn't even know you were awake.
Oh god. I don't miss my bubble.
Yeah.
I do not miss my bubble one bit.
Uh-huh.
Why does the front end of this car look so weird? The whole car looks weird.
It looks like it's supposed to be a fancy car.
Looks like it's supposed to be like a... I don't know. It looks too weird for me. All right, come on. Why is Flossie always so edgy and butter?
I love Flossie.
So edgy. Have a seat. Why you like this?
Why? What'd I do?
You moved the chair, didn't you? And you threw the chair for me.
I didn't touch the chair. I didn't touch the chair.
You know, okay, I'm going to give you...
the table for sure, but I didn't touch the chair.
I'm going to give you a life hack. I'm going to give you a life hack, right?
All right, yes.
Just think about placing yourself in the chair. Have you worked out what I mean by that yet?
No.
Okay, your F1 muscle. Yeah.
Uh-huh.
Then you know what to go into next. And then place. Welcome.
Okay.
Okay, for some reason that made me sink into the chair. What the fuck did I just do?
Oh my god, wait, this is, how do I, you know what? Give me a second.
Uh-huh.
Oh my god!
Yeah, you're welcome. Did I just change the world?
Oh my god.
Did I just change everything for you?
Oh my god, yes. Wait, this is awesome. This is...
Hey, look. Oh. Fuck me. Fucking chair. I can do this. I'm struggling. I can do this. I can do this.
Sit down, Reggie.
I'm just going to cheat. Anyway, then you can do things like this.
This is awesome.
Yeah. You're welcome. Anyway, Ellie.
Reggie.
Has life been tough to you?
It's definitely had its moments, yeah.
So how much money have you got in your bank? Fucking camera.
Like $5,000.
Oh, you're a broke boy, right?
Listen, I can't wake up.
You can't afford cookies.
I can't. No, not really.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Right.
I'm trying.
So what are your goals, Ellie? Like, where do you see yourself going? Like, what's happening with you? Surely you have something you're working towards.
I mean, a car, house, but I wanted to get back into, like, business stuff again, because before I left for New York, I really enjoyed, you know, working at a bunch of places and being rich, you know?
Mm.
And then, I don't know, just having people, you know, having people around me again.
Right. So you're wanting to live the clean life for as long as possible? Or are you wanting to get your hands dirty? What's happening?
I think I would get my hands dirty for the right, like, the right reasons. I just, like, I don't know what that is, you know? Like, I know that people are growing weed and stuff, and that's not really my thing. Like, I've never been big on the weed.
Yeah, I feel
but
that.
But, like, you know, if there was meth and things like that, like, I've always enjoyed doing that sort of stuff. So I would get my hands dirty for a little bit of meth.
Right.
So I'm, like, right now, because I don't know too much, I'm pretty much just, like, trying to get my money up, doing just things when I can, and then down the line, like I said, for the right reasons, I would definitely get my hands dirty.
Well, Ellie, you know, all those years back, I feel like we missed an opportunity with you, and I was pushing for you hard. And obviously Seaside's no longer a thing, right?
Yeah.
So, in the future, not now, in the future, myself, KJ, and Benji will be looking at organizing something. So the three of us will be doing something, and it's not going to be a game. Right?
Okay.
Please hold. Hello, Dahlia. I'm just having a meeting.
Okay.
Yeah. What's up?
I'm awake, so I'm letting you know.
Oh, did you just wake up?
Yeah, I did.
Holy, what the fuck is wrong with you?
Everything. I might go back to bed later, but I can't sleep, so I'm awake.
Okay. Well, I'll give you a call after the meeting, all right?
Okay. Sounds good.
Goodbye. All right,
bye.
Holy fuck, Dahlia's usually not awake till like a couple of hours before I'm going to bed. This is... Yeah, right. Hello, Aristotelian. I am having fun. You'll be having a good day.
Shift.
Yeah, that's taken me back. Okay. I thought she was about to tell me she's going to bed. Not that she just woke up. Anyway. So, what we're looking at isn't a gang, right? Not gonna be the gang shooty fucking hold down our turf kind of shit thing that the past was. However, I'm not gonna sit here and say it's a family, it's this, it's that. We have a clear goal in mind on what we want to do, but we're not sharing that exactly yet. Right?
Yeah.
But what we are doing is we're letting people know that eventually we're gonna come knocking. Now the people that we're gonna take with us and to do the things that we're doing are going to be people that have established themselves in the city, have a name for themselves, and have worth. Because last time it was no hidden fact that Seaside took in people that were along for the ride, right?
Mm-hmm.
And not really making a name for themselves. They were so-and-so from Seaside.
Yeah.
We don't want people to live in the shadow of whatever we're doing. We want people to be their own person. Like, look at myself, KJ, and Benji, for example, right? We talk to multiple different people. We have our own things. We're very well established by ourselves. And that's the kind of people that we're looking for as well. So we're telling people early so they can start working towards that if they feel like that's something that they would want to come along for and help grow. Just need to stress the fact that by no means is this going to be a game. Sammy, thank you for gifting the tier one.
Okay.
So I think that it's, I'm reaching out to people that I think are going to be beneficial for this and letting yous know early on to start working towards that goal, grouping with other people and start information gathering, start getting your name out there, make yourself known and work towards something specific. So I'm also letting you know as well, I'm going to be talking with Mari and Yuki.
I saw Yuki last night. I was so happy.
Oh, I fucked with Yuki yesterday.
Oh, really?
Yeah, I kind of asked her if she wanted to marry me. God damn it, I was going to do that to you too and just fuck with you. Fuck.
Oh, I forgot. Valdez and I are still together.
I have a whole thing. It was funny that Mari played into it as well and Yuki didn't know what to do. Oh. It was fantastic. But yeah, I'm going to be talking to them as well. I want a diverse group of people that are smart and capable of doing things by themselves, but also working with other people.
Yeah.
I don't want like a lone wolf. I don't want someone who just wants to come along for the ride and offer nothing themselves. And I've said to some of the ex-Seaside boys that if they don't do these things, they will not be invited. It's just as simple as that. You can't actually make a name for yourself in the city and start working towards something, then I'm sorry, you're not coming.
Yeah.
Essentially no freeloaders this time.
Yeah, I think that's a
good thing. It was no hidden fact that because of how established Seaside was, it was easier for people to get things. They got a lot of handouts and were able to do things that they wanted to without any kind of struggle.
Yeah.
And someone ends up being deep in debt because they didn't wake up to pay their loans, then some of the Seasiders would help and get that person back up. You don't want to fall into that same trap.
Yeah.
That's something you could see yourself doing in the future?
I mean, I've always wanted to like be my own person as well. It was when I was doing the business things before, like when I didn't have BBMC, I was lost for a bit until I figured out that I didn't need a group. I just wanted one, you know, and I was perfectly fine doing the things that I enjoyed. Took me a little bit to get there, but I got there.
Yeah, I mean, for me, is when I actually started doing a lot of my own things is when I realized the trap that people fall into just staying in their gang and working with the people in the gang, and then you become the person that has all these different connects, and then the people in the gang go to you to use your connects instead of getting their own.
Yeah.
And that shit becomes frustrating because you worked for these things and the other people just see it as a given. Now,
constantly pulling favors for other people instead of them putting in the work to build the connections themselves.
Yeah, yeah. So once we do decide to put this plan in actual motion and move forward with it, we're going to have a good group of people that have their own connections, and if they need to go and get something, they don't need to ask someone else unless their person can't get it. And then that works in favor for everyone then, because everyone's working towards the same goal. However, they're their own individual cog in this machine.
Mm-hmm.
So that's our idea and what we want to play into. But it's going to be nothing the same as what Seaside was. Not going to be Seaside, nothing like that. But the three of us do have a goal in mind and what we want. We're just not going to share it at the moment because it's not ready to run. At the moment, Benji's doing his own thing with a group of people. With I'm doing
Ray and Mickey and all them. Yeah, I saw him today.
Which then will help in the long run when he comes and we set all this up. Because he's been getting a lot of information. I've been getting a lot of information from different people as well. So everyone that we're talking to also needs to be a little information sponge and try and get information from other people about things, because it's going to help you.
Mm-hmm.
Like, for example, finding out where the locals are and which ones to talk to, finding new ones, working out what is going to be a clear path you want to work on. At the moment, I'm still staying legal because I need to pay for treatments for myself. So, I lose 10 grand every 2 weeks for this treatment. So I'm going to be perpetually broke for a while and having to work my ass off and having to do all legal jobs to get that money because I don't want the hospitals asking questions.
Yeah.
However, doesn't mean that I can't start putting people on their own paths and doing stuff. Like at the moment, Dre's focusing his ass off on weed, which I think is going to be beneficial in the fact that weed is a gateway drug. We all know this, right? And who knows, maybe once you start getting your rep up with weed, maybe another dealer might approach you and say, hey, how about start working on this?
Yeah.
Because that's not too much of a far-fetched idea that it is possible.
No, with the way that other things have been, it definitely does make sense.
So we're trying to get people to diversify. I've also been working a bit with Michael Dahlia and all that. They're doing their own thing. They're not going to end up being a part of this, I don't think, because Michael and Benji are still having their falling out. It's fun.
Okay.
But, wanted to talk to you about it and let you know and have that little thought in your head for when we decide to push forward with it. If it's something you want to jump on board with, I'd want to have you come along with us, providing you follow those steps that I said.
Yeah, I'll definitely consider it. And like I said, I would, even without you coming in telling me all this, I would have wanted to make a name for myself anyway, because I don't want to be a nobody, you know? I think I have a lot of skills that I just need to showcase, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah. So start working on you're getting everything you want to. Has people given you like information about certain things, and you know about stuff like your storages and like certain people, like what you do with the bags and all that kind of stuff?
So I knew about the storages, but I only just had the need to get some because of all the materials I got today. So I've got storages now. I know about the fence guy and you know, trading in the grime and the group 6 stuff. I know about the dirty money. I know how to clean it all.
Yeah.
So yeah, I've got like the basics, and I feel like every day I'm getting more information as well. I found a couple of the locals. Still don't know where the guy that used to be in the Oxy Alley moved to, and we found him one day, and then the next day he up and moved. So
I feel like a lot of people found that person.
Yeah.
And he's now gone into hiding. Yeah. So what areas have you found people?
So there's the fentanyl guy behind the old fishing spot.
Yeah. In Tongva.
The turf guy up by like just outside of Harmony. You know about that one?
No, actually, that's a new one for me.
Yeah, so the I think it's like an abandoned gas station. There's a turf seller.
Okay. Which gas station?
There's a race that starts out there. Let me see if I can remember roughly where it is. So it's on Route 68, and I think it's near the approach. Like, I would know it when I drove.
Oh, the gas station's like, there. Okay.
Yeah, not the one where you like used to drop off cars, but like across the road.
Yeah, I know the one you're talking about.
So he's behind that building.
Has anyone shown you the one that's in Sandy?
No.
But you haven't heard the name Desert Viper?
No, I haven't. We were talking last night about if there was something in Sandy, but we didn't like look around there.
So there is. The one in Sandy is, if you keep going, so you go into Sandy, right? You'll see a big Christmas tree there, the star on the top. You go to the north of it, the block over, you'll see this little shack that it looks like it's half burnt out and broken down and that kind of shit. And there's a little campfire there. You go through the door, and you'll see Desert Viper there. They'll tell you to fuck off.
Okay.
But that's where he is.
Okay, I might have to go and check that out later then.
Yeah. Any other ones you found?
Obviously I know about the weed person and like, you know, under the bridge and heading up to Grape Seed. I'm trying to think, like, Jamie, I don't know if you remember, Jamie used to hang out at Haze a bit. He's very good. He's shown me a lot of the ones that I'm telling you about. He's very resourceful like that too. I know that Valdez was trying to figure out like the pawn shop guy because he's just like constantly on his lunch break.
Yeah. He just never wanted to talk to me.
Yeah. And we're also trying to figure out where the Wi-Fi spots are too. So that's what a lot of last night we were just driving around checking for any sort of Wi-Fi signal.
Yeah.
Didn't have any luck.
I haven't found any either.
Yeah.
All right. You found most of the ones that I've found, and you had one that I hadn't found, and I've got one you found, so it works for both of us. But yeah, just keep trying to get information from people.
Yeah, I will.
All right. Well, that's all I wanted to really have a chat to you.
Okay. Yeah.
You have any other questions for it?
No, not really. I'm just, when I am around, I'm just trying to stay productive, you know? Whether it's making money or, like I said last night, I didn't make any money, but we were trying to gather information last night.
Yeah.
So I'm always trying to do something.
Don't get stuck in the way where you don't branch out to new people and find new people to help, because a lot of new people have good information. Just don't give everything away and sometimes act clueless to those new people. See what they give you.
Yeah, definitely. I said I got hired at the mechanic shop, so I imagine I'd meet some more people there as well, because everyone's gonna need their stuff fixed.
Yeah. All right. Well, I'll let you get back to your day.
All right.
Gotta have a chat with Mari.
While I was doing group six.
Okay.
Gotta go have another conversation.
Interesting. Look at you, hot commodity, huh?
Someone that I haven't talked to in a very, very, very long time.
Okay. All right. Where do you want me to take you?
Honestly, I can probably just get them to pick me up.
All right.
have your conversation. I've saved your number. I'm sure you've saved mine now too, so.
No.
Oh, that's fucked up.
Yeah, I just called you from the other pages.
I will try to be around again, you know, tonight and over the next few days, but we'll see what happens.
Yeah, I mean, if you do, just, if any of the people want to hang out with you, do stuff with the other ones that I spoke to you about, and, you know, start moving yourself forward, make a name.
Yeah, I was hanging out with Dre the other night for a little bit. I saw Louie today as well, so we were doing some Sandy together.
All right. Want me to hang here while you wait for him?
No, you're good. I'll give him a call now and get him to pick me up.
All right. I'll be around for a while, so if you need anything, just give me a call, all right?
Yeah, right back at you.
All right. See you later.
Bye.
All right. One conversation done. Fuck Louie. Let's call Dahlia back.
Hello.
What up?
Me, unfortunately.
Oh, okay. How's life going?
It's going. How are you?
Living the dream. I need to make more money today, so I'm not so close to my 10 grand mark, and I'm hoping to get like 12 grand today.
Okay.
So we'll see how we go. I saw Mari just woke up, so she's usually the go-to little fucking grinder with me. What are your plans today?
Well, I'm working down at Mosley's because his job started paying.
How's that going
for you? Experience. Well, I need to kind of grind Mosley's. So, to both get money and experience. So,
how are you going money wise? I know that you haven't really been making much door mechanic stuff.
Not great. But if Mari is busy and you want to do something, it is a two-person job, so. Or it can be a two-person job.
How's the pay go for it?
It's not horrible. So, I mean, it's enough that everybody in the fucking city is a mechanic right now.
Oh my god, that's annoying.
Yeah. Yeah, it's incredibly annoying, actually. Because, like, I need to do it so I can actually get better at fixing cars. Yeah. Yes, I would like to make money, but we just have these other people who I know have jobs other places coming in, and you know. Yep.
That's frustrating.